that point in time, when I was speaking to the guy, I said, oh, Charlie, the scratches and things, let's try. And then the guy said, oh, why don't you re-spray it to a different color? I said, okay, that's fine, no problem, we can just re-spray it. And so that is what happened. And so one day I was at home and I got a call and said, oh, John, some people there from national security, they say you for come. I said, okay, no problem. So I got there and then they said, okay, so this vehicle is for the national security. I said, okay, can you explain to me? Then they put in the chassis number, and then in the chassis number it said imported for the national security. No problem. I said, okay, fine, no problem. Then I called the guy that sold it to me. I said, oh, boss, this is what the people are saying, blah, blah, blah. Then he said he'll get back to me, but he wants to deal with them. Then, so at that point in time, it's like, oh, hey, this vehicle is for them, blah, blah, blah. And then they took the vehicle away.
A vehicle you have not fully paid for.
Yes.
A vehicle you know very well belongs to the government of Ghana.
Yes.
You took it to a spray shop, but and you were changing the color.
No, but you
that
see,
would amount to ill intent.
Yes, yes. But you see, at that point in time when I was paying for the vehicle, it's not a matter of it's for the government owner. It's a matter of, okay, John, when you finish paying, we'll just do the change of ownership.
Yeah, but it was a government car.
Yes.
You know, there are special duties on government cars and so on.
But
so you were benefiting from your association with the government.
No, but I paid for it.
Yeah, but you have not given us how much, so we can't even prove.
Yes, but
you have the receipts.
Yes, but I've paid for it.
Yeah, so if you paid for something,
yes,
you should fight for it. You don't give up
exactly
easily.
And so fighting for it is between me and the person or the people.
The company. It was running
that
organization.
The person or the people that sold the vehicle to me.
Did you take them on?
And so I spoke to them and I said, John, you know what? We'll sort it out. After 2-3 months, I paid my balance and I bought a new car.
So they gave you a new car?
I've paid the balance and I bought a new car.
I don't get it. You gave the balance to the company and they gave you a new car.
And I bought a new car, yes.
No, you didn't buy a new car.
I mean,
So they gave you a new car to replace the one that was taken by the government.
Perfectly.
Was it a V8?
Yes.
I see. You don't think that what you were doing was fraudulent?
No, at all. There's nothing fraudulent about it. If
you mentioned if, the if, former